Yes, a very good evening to all of you. I hope you can see me, hear me properly. Just do respond in the comment section if you can hear me properly, if you can see me. How are you? A very good evening to all of you. Yes, a very good evening to all of you. Good evening, good evening. So we are starting with the test series with the live discussion. And apart from this, if you are interested in the batch of economics optional, we're starting from tomorrow with paper 2. And this batch will be completed before your mains examination this time. This test series, you can find the schedule, link given in the description of the website, where you will go in the home page, you will find the schedule and the link for the test series. Okay. So yes, a very good evening. कैसे हैं आप लोग? हाउ वॉज योर प्रिलिमिनरी एग्जाम? हाउ वॉज योर प्रिलिमिनरी एग्जाम? आई होप यू हैव अपीयर्ड दिस टाइम. सो विल सी द स्ट्रैटेजी हाउ वी कैन अप्रोच इट एंड हाउ वी कैन अप्रोच द ऑप्शनल इन पर्टिकुलर, वेयर वॉट टू फोकस, वॉट नॉट टू फोकस, वॉट आर द सोर्सेज दैट यू नीड. ओके, सो दीज आर द थिंग्स दैट वी विल show you. Okay. Yes, good evening. Good evening, Chinmay. How are you? Okay, so we'll start with this. I can see your comments. You can also see comments on the screen. Now, the important thing that we need to discuss is what is economics optional and how important it is. Okay. So some of my students were saying that they were scoring around 110, and in between I have some students who have scored around 105 104, some of them scored 99 95. So this is the average that I got. Okay, although it was a tough one, but tough for everyone. Okay, because it's the exam that do not expect you to correct all the 100 questions. The exam is all about relativity. So it's like how good you are from the another person. So one thing is, so if you are not able to tackle the questions from agriculture and other things, no worry, because every student has also faced the same thing. So it is easy for everyone, tough for everyone, but it's about that how easy question you are able to tackle, minimizing your mistakes in the easy question and maximizing your some of the guesswork in the tough question. So this is the game between these two. Now, although preliminary is the old thing and you must have seen all types of analysis of the questions and other, I hope economy you find it easy. Now talk about the mains, because this is the time of mains. If you have qualified or if you're not qualified, what you need to prepare for the next attempt, or you can have to prepare for the mains examination. So in both the cases you have to start with optional subject. Optional plays an important role. Why? Because if you see the score of general studies, in the general studies, every student gets around on an average marks. So it means all the candidates starting from the first rank to the last rank, they got around decent marks on an average marks. The difference is there. Difference is there where in the essay and the two optional paper. So essay paper and the two optional paper. Now, what is the important thing that we need to understand here? That if you try to score around 300 or 325 in economics optional, it is possible. Because if you see the paper 1 and paper 2, in paper 1, more or less the conceptual based thing they will ask. Like Chinmay is there. He is my student of economics optional batch, currently ongoing batch. Now, he was not very comfortable with the graph, but after the microeconomics classes, he is very comfortable in the graph. And I hope, Chinmay, if you are listening to me right now, I think graphical representation is one of the easiest representation, because this is the point where UPSC cannot deduct your marks. They have to give, because it is like a conceptual based. If they will ask the assumption of certain model and you have to prove something like the consumer's equilibrium, the producer's equilibrium, or you need to find like equilibrium of the monopoly, monopolistic market, where you have to make graph, explain it, that's it, if they will ask. Okay, so the question is, whatever they have asked, if you can provide that in your answer copy, then you will fetch good marks. Because in paper 2, generally people find it easy, but the question is, in paper 2, answer writing is tough. Because suppose, for example, if you think about the assumptions in the paper 1, you compare with the paper 2. Now suppose in paper 1, I will say, write the assumption of Heckscher-Ohlin model. Okay. In paper 2, I will say, write the main features of MNREGA. I hope you can understand the difference between these two. Now here, assumptions of Heckscher-Ohlin is prescribed, is predefined. But features of MNREGA can be anything. Maybe 5 points in someone's answer copy, maybe 10 points in some other answer copy. So the difference comes here, when the question is easy, writing answer is difficult. Okay, na? So we can say the most important thing is, when the question is easy, the answer writing becomes more difficult. When the question is tough, answer writing becomes easy. But answer writing becomes easy when you are able to prepare well before the exam. Because they are asking some of the new topics, some small topics between the, we can say, market structure, factor pricing, and welfare economics. So in microeconomics, these are the important part. In market structure, if you will ask me, the most important market is monopolistic competition. Now the monopolistic competition, what does it mean? It means, this is the point where we can say that another important concept that we need to understand here is that in paper 2, if you find certain questions related to any government scheme, it's difficult to write. Okay, now Hitesh, I don't know what you are asking, what kind of logic is this, but the logic is very simple. The important second important thing to prepare for economics option is to revise, because in economics or in any optional, they ask directly from the syllabus. They ask questions directly from the syllabus. So pick out the syllabus lines and prepare on that. What I can suggest you, what I've done as well, because I'm teaching economics optional, what I've done is simply the simple thing, one topic in one A4 size page. Because you will get the time and the space limited. If you read too much, obviously you'll not be able to write that much. So it's better to read small things, less things, read it multiple times, and then try to reproduce it in the examination hall. Okay, so this is the main thing, always remember. The another important thing about the preparation, now how you can divide these 3 months that you have. In these 3 months, what you can do is, you have to devote most of the time to your optional, because you already know general studies if you are able to qualify. What you need is the answer writing practice only. So it's answer writing practice is important. For general studies, you do that. Read newspaper and rest of the time read optional. Whatever optional you have, right now you are talking about economics optional. So economics optional is an important thing, okay. Now understanding another important part, that if you are preparing, if you are revising a lot, it means then you are able to reproduce. If you will not revise, you will not able to feel confident before the exam. So feeling confidence, like a lot of students say, and they come to me and they say that, sir, we are not feeling confident. We know everything, but we are somehow not feeling confident. So this confidence comes with the category of your preparation and revision. Because if you do not revise, it is difficult to reproduce or recall. Because in examination, we generally work on 50% efficiency. Our brain doesn't work the way it works in our time of preparation, or the way it is working in your study table, on your study table. Okay. So the issue is that in examination hall, you need to write certain points, and these points must be important in this, in what scenario? It is important in terms of the structure. The second thing is important that we are talking about, maybe the third point, the content is important, but context is also important. If suppose they will ask the question related to flexible or fixed exchange rate in paper 1, Now, the concepts are important. You have to understand the concept and the difference between these two. But another important thing that we need to discuss is context. Why UPSC asked this question? Why UPSC asked this question? So in this context, what we can understand that why? Because China is manipulating its exchange rate, because China followed the fixed exchange rate, and United States of America is having certain problem with that. So by deliberately devaluing its currency against some other hard currencies, China was misusing just to boost the export. So this was the major we can say bone of contention between US and China, and trade war has been going on since last 2 years. So you can expect the question related to the exchange rate as well as related to trade war. Okay, so these are the important things. Now let's we can take our questions, and the questions, if something will come, I'll let you know. So someone is asking that is gate preparation help in UPSC? I think it's not at all. UPSC economics option and gate are two very different examination, different in terms of syllabus, different in terms of the questions and the approach. Next question that we have from Deepika, sir, when to start optional if it is your master's subject? I think the best time when you start your master degree, then I think it's a good time to start. Shubham is asking, sir, is economics a good option for UPSC for the one who is doing BA economics honors? I think Shubham, it's very useful for you, because in order to study a new subject, totally new subject, starting from scratch, it's better to study the subject that you have in your graduation, because in that you will be familiar with the terms, the subjects, the models, the theories. And if you'll not take optional in the interview, they will ask why you have chosen other optional when you are graduate in BA economics honors. Next question, sir, I'm good but MCQs but not able to recall different ideas. Different ideas in the sense, I think if you are not able to recall, the only thing missing in your preparation is revision. If you do not revise a lot, what I do is like I revise a lot before the class. So on the same lines, what you can do is, in order to understand the chronology of any topic, okay, that you have to revise well, and it should be in your notes. You have to write on pen and paper. Do not make notes on the laptop or the screen or drive or word file, because at the end of the day in the examination you have to write with pen and paper. So if you will not get into like habit of writing with pen and paper, it will be difficult. Next that we have Madhusmita. So the syllabus is vast, how to cover in limited time? I think the syllabus is decent enough. I will not say it's very vast if we compare with the whole economics. So the syllabus, maybe I can say the vast syllabus is related to paper 2, because in paper 2 there are haphazard things that may come. Okay, so here the issue is that we need to understand about the limited time, and you have to divide these 90 days into, if you put the syllabus and divide in 90 days and try to make a timetable properly and try to cover the topics. So you see, you have two things, syllabus and question paper. You just match it and prepare the notes from that. I think this would be the best strategy that I can suggest to you. Next is economics optional language, Hindi or English best rahega? Dekho, if you can take English, obviously take English, because in Hindi there are limited sources. Sources ki kami hai. Books nahi milega aapko, newspaper mein takleef jayega. Parvez Alam is asking, sir, I am taking coaching of economics optional. Should I read advanced microeconomics of Ahuja since I have notes of coaching? See, notes and these study material are different thing, but if you feel that these notes are not able to suffice your syllabus, see the syllabus and previous year question paper. If it is not able to suffice, then obviously you have to read HL Ahuja. Micro is a foundation. If you're not good in micro, obviously it is difficult to clear. Next is, hello sir, can we use the approach one topic, one page? Yes, you can approach, you can adopt that approach, but there's one demerit in that approach is, if the syllabus is pretty vast, if that particular topic is vast, obviously you have to subdivide that. Subdivision means that many pages, okay. Next is, it is important to cover each and every topic mentioned in the syllabus. I think, Madhu Smita, it is very important to cover each and every topic in the syllabus, because syllabus is not too vast. Okay, so I think it's very, very, very important to cover each and every topic of the syllabus. You cannot leave, because UPSC cannot ask beyond syllabus. They will ask only within the syllabus. Then on any other optional, like, see, the strategy would remain same, but I don't know about psychology. I teach economics. Then Muzamil is asking, how can complete ECO in minimum time with revision, because my preliminary exam is 27 June. I think you are preparing for the next year, so I think it's better to prepare now, and you try to finish it before this mains examination. And do one thing, when you prepare, write the paper in the January, write the paper at your home. Okay, because you are not going to attempt that, so it's better to write at home. I think we are starting with the batch as well tomorrow. So this is, you can see, there's a batch. Next that we have, Akhilesh is saying, good evening. Yeah, good evening, Akhilesh, how are you? Madhu Smita is asking, can we skip any? I think if you can skip, it's on your own risk, because they will give the choice, and that choice you have to attempt the question. And in between, suppose you have left growth and development, then obviously in that particular question, if there are three parts, two from growth and development, then you'll be in trouble. Okay. Next that we have, Richa is asking, sir, I haven't appeared exam yet. I'm thinking to take economics as optional. Is it good optional? I think the question in your mind, that economics option is a good optional or not, I would rather say it's a very decent optional, because it will cover your 500 marks in the mains examination, then another 125 marks every time in the form of any one essay. Apart from this, 50 marks in, suppose, the international relation, that will help, in economic history, that will help, and some of the case study related to economics, that will also help. So more or less, we can say 500 plus 125 and another 50 marks, you can say. So it's almost 700 marks that economics optional is helping you out. Apart from this, in preliminary also, it will give you 20-25 questions. And the weightage of economy is going up, like economy, environment and other things. So weightage of that has been going up. So it's better to, it's a good choice you can take. Adi Pranav is saying, when will you start data analytics classes? I think, Adi, it's very hectic right now, just because of the Indian Economic Service exam, the NIT exam we have just concluded, and the optional. So I can't promise any date, but I'll start soon. So you just download the app, you'll get the notification if we'll start. Next that we have, which book is good for paper 1 and paper 2? Suresh, there's no single book, but I have a list of books. So you can just download the app. There is a one video where you can watch all the books I have explained. Satyam Singh is asking, how much time will it take to cover the whole syllabus of economics option? I think minimum 3 months, maximum 4 months. And if you are new to the subject, like you are from engineering background, it may take 4.5 to 5 months. Next is, Aman is asking, sir, will the optional classes starting tomorrow helpful for the people appearing in this mains, that is in January? Yes, Aman, because we are going to finish the syllabus before December anyhow, whether you are attempting for June or this time, we have to finish the syllabus before December. So what we do, we provide live classes. All the classes will be live classes. Study material you'll get via post to your postal address. You'll get weekly test, like today is Sunday, you'll get a weekly test for that. And you will also get a live session for your previous year question discussion. So we do discuss those as well. So these are the major features. Apart from this, you can see the other feature on the website. All classes are live classes. What we do is we try to organize two sessions. Right now we are having only evening session, but we will also have morning session. So in the morning session, you will get the classes as well. So we'll be able to cover by 15th or 20th December. Okay, the next is, sir, new batches for economics option starting tomorrow. Okay, Shubham Shah is asking, sir, please tell me the roadmap to prepare economics option in UPSC. I'm the first year pursuing BA economics. I think I have explained a lot of things, but still, if you want my personal attention, you can call me tomorrow 11 a.m. Numbers are flashing on the screen. This is my official number. If you call me between 11 to 12, okay, between 11 to 12, I'll be available on the phone. Next that we have, will the gate preparation would be helpful for net JRF? Yes, Rohit, that can be done, but gate level would be more than in comparison to net. Next question is, for economics optional, should I follow extra newspaper or other? I don't think so. You just read the business page and of the Hindu and Express. Okay, Indian Express and the Hindu. Next that we have, for economics optional. Oh, I've done this. Next is Kundan Soni. Sir, is it possible to complete entire subject of economics option in 2 to 3 months? I think it depends on your past knowledge. If you are preparing for like for some time, it would be easy. If you are new to the subject, I would say it is impossible to cover in 2-3 months. Satyam is saying, sir, I'm facing problem in the basic algebra like Cobb-Douglas production function. What should I do? Can I skip topic calculus, algebra, even the basic? I think they do not ask mathematics, they do not ask statistics or econometrics. They are not having in the syllabus. What they ask is, they ask simple equations. So simple equation like a relationship equation, okay, these are not mathematics. So no need to read calculus or algebra for optional. What you can do is, in the microeconomics, these are the simple symbols, okay, where we represent, because in graph we have a limitation of 2 dimension. But in order to accommodate more variables, more than 2, so it will be helpful to use equations. Okay, then we have, sir, please suggest me mathematical economics book. Anant, it's A.C. Chiang. A.C. Chiang is a book for mathematical economics. So that you can buy, and you will find a lot of good content in it. Okay. So I'll paste the link for the course. Okay, and I'll paste the link for test series as well. If you are prepared enough, then you can go for test series. Okay. Next that we have, Suchiang is asking, sir, in paper 2 we have to need to apply graph diagram or not? In paper 2 there will be no diagram, it's purely theoretical Indian economy. Okay, sir, I can't understand ecotypically word, due to which I have many confusion related to graphical treatment. Please give me some tips to quick understand ecotypical word. I think you should start from 12th class NCRT. If you are able to understand the microeconomics of 12th class NCRT, that will be helpful. Okay, next that we have is, sir, in economics optional, how should I approach for numericals? See, they ask very minimal numericals. Okay, in the numericals, these are not the numericals, they are just equilibrium, like the quantity supply and quantity demand, so income determination model. Then they have IS and LM model. Okay, then they have what, if we talk about other cost functions, they ask, okay, Cobb-Douglas production function. So no need to like go for full mathematical. You will find these equation in advanced HL Ahuja as well, and we do provide in the course as well, in the classes we do provide. Okay, next that we have is Sonali is asking, sir, how many pages we write our mains examination? I think it depends on the number of marks allotted to a particular question. Okay, so I think it's more than 30 pages, 30-35 pages that you have to do. Next that we have, Sagar, is it feasible for non-economics background student to take economics as an option? I think, Sagar, it's a good idea. If you are from engineering background, a lot of students take economics option. Like in my batch, recent batch, I have 85 students in that, and half of them are engineer. Next, Aman Gupta, does the optional course include test series? No, that optional course includes weekly test. Okay, weekly test is also having the level equivalent to that, but test series is a different, because in test series, a lot of experienced faculty those who have certain past experience in evaluating the copies, they check your copy. So that is a separate thing because that comes with the cost. Vivek is asking, sir, for IES, from which topics should I start? Is it microeconomics? I think it's microeconomics, or before that, it's better to start with mathematical economics. If you are preparing for Indian Economic Service, okay, this session is for economics options, so I cannot tell you more than that. Leonardo is asking, sir, in how many months you will complete the course? Right now, I will complete by December. Siddharth, talking about undergraduate, we'll do it later. But economics, mathematics, tech, this is in UG. And today's our topic is economics option. Someone is saying if classes are paid or free. I think obviously the classes are paid because live classes comes with certain cost. Okay, so it's not free. Pooja is asking, say 2 months course will be completed. No, not in 2 months. By 15th of December, most probably. Satyam is asking, how can I enroll? So I think the link I have given in the topics in the comment section, so you can see. Next is Kaushik is asking, sir, please tell the best coaching of economics option in Delhi. I think right now offline is not, so we are also operating from Delhi. So it's like you can join us. We are starting with the batch tomorrow. Okay, so this is the detail of the economics optional batch, and this is the test series. Today we have started with the test series. Tomorrow we are starting with the batch, daily live classes. Pooja is asking, what's the duration of the course? Duration, right now it's 3 months. Again, Pooja is asking same thing. So right now the duration is 3 months because we are taking double classes per day. Usually we take one class per day, but for this year, we will take two classes per day. Next is someone is asking, Deepanshu is asking, I am in class 12 science. Can I take up BSc economics? I want to pursue civil service. Will it be? No, I don't think so. BSc economics would be easy for you. If you start with the graduation level, it will help you in your UPSC preparation. Okay. Then we have, I think, some repeat question once again. Someone is asking about CLATs. CDR, this is for optional, I cannot tell about other exams. So which book is the best for macro, Ahuja, Froen or Dominic? See, Pervez, macroeconomics is a typical thing here. I think post-Keynesian model is best given in Froen. And apart from this, you will find in HL Ahuja as well. So Froen is must for post-Keynesian topic. Aman Gupta is saying, sir, if I join the test series a bit late, can I attempt the previous? Yes, yes, you can attempt the previous test and all the previous discussion will be available, because in test series, we have a live discussion of all the tests. So you'll get that. Economics optional duration. Okay. Rahul is asking, sir, my medium is English, but I face difficulty in speaking English. See, Rahul, here you have to write it. If you are able to write it, that's enough, because you will get enough time to prepare for speaking skills before interview. Okay. No, Rahul, it will not create any problem. Later on, you can learn. Okay. English is a language you can learn. It's not a rocket science. Okay. Next is Leonard is asking, sir, I have done graduation BCom with economics. I have good hand in economics, but optional books are of different level. Can you please tell me how many days can I complete the whole preparation? I think if you try to give full 100%, it means almost 6 to 8 hours per day, then it would be easy to complete the whole syllabus in 4 months. Next, Harsh is asking, I want to know the jobs offer in economics. Harsh, there's a separate video, career prospects in economics. You can just scroll down in the video section. You'll find all the career prospects that I've explained there. Does economic consist BA and MA syllabus? See, Pooja, UPSC has their own syllabus, so they have given that. Next question is, sir, I want to meet you with you, please, please, please. I will meet after coronavirus, okay? Next is Harsh is asking, sir, what are the jobs? Harsh had already told you, okay. Shivam is asking how we can enroll for the classes. Link is given in the comment section. If you just scroll up, you'll find the link for the test series and for the other things. Okay. So you can see this is test series. And if you want the link of the course, that I also paste here. Okay, these are the links. Rahul is saying, sir, please reduce the price of it. Rahul, we are not for profit, okay? So we do not charge anything extra. If you see the optional price in the markets, more than 4 times what we are having the fees, okay? So it's already discounted after April. We cannot go beyond that, because if we go below that, the system will not be able to run, okay? Next is, sir, I'm getting good marks in the economics optional of UPSC. How optional of UPSC different from UPPSC? I think the state services exam optional are very easy. They are very easy. They do not ask questions like a conceptual base. They ask direct questions. So what is, like, it is written in the production function. So they will ask what is production function. Okay. So these kind of topics they ask. But in civil services, UPSC, they ask conceptual based, analytical based question. Okay. Next is Harsh is saying, I'm in IHE doing BA economics honors with maths. Tell me some benefit, sir, please. See, Harsh, benefits are many, because without maths, high level economics, there is like no use of that. If you are studying economics without mathematics, it is of no use in modern times. Okay, for economics optional, maths is not required, but since you are asking me other things, so yes. See, the person username with Himalayan, I think UPPSC, what you are asking, the optional subject is very straightforward, okay? They do not ask very technical questions, so just cover the syllabus, see the previous year paper, and it will be a cakewalk. It will be like a semester exam, okay? Rahul is saying, please upload some of the lectures on YouTube. I watched your lecture. Yeah, I'm trying to upload it. I'm not able to find some time because I teach for 10 hours live per day on Ecoholics mobile app. So sometimes it's difficult, but I'll try my best, maybe in few weeks, because I've completed a lot of batches recently and they have their exam in the coming weeks. So I'll try. I'll keep your suggestion, Rahul. Thank you so much for your appreciation. Okay. Next that we have is, sir, if a student is not graduate with economics but want to explore economics, what's the way? I think there are a lot of ways you can explore it, like by having a degree, or you just want to read books. What is your main thing? Yeah, Jatin is saying, do you teach Ecotricks? Yes, Ecotricks batch is also there, live batch. Daily morning 9 to 10 a.m. Okay, you'll find in the link of the course. Okay, so there's a link you can find all the courses of Ecotricks and other. Next question we have, sir, I don't studied mathematics in my 12th, will it affect BA economics honors in? I think it depends where you are enrolling, Shubham. So if you are enrolling in the universities like Delhi University, GNU, it will affect, but you have to learn mathematics if you want to excel in economics. Now that too, not pure mathematics, just few concepts like differentiation, matrices, calculus, okay. Pooja, apart from lecture, no need to prepare anything. Just read the study material, what we will give, and see the lectures carefully. Lectures are the heart and soul of your preparation, okay? Next that we have, sir, I'm working professional. I'm unable to attend the live class, so recorded class. See, if you're not able to attend the live class, like on YouTube, once I will finish this live session, it will be converted into a recorded one, okay? So the same thing that will happen on app. If I will take some class, it will be uploaded in the form of recorded one later on. Next that we have, sir, Ashish is asking, sir, in 2019 there was a couple of questions in the paper one. Yes, I know, but these are not mathematical questions. These are relationship based question of the equation. Next that we have, sir, this year pre is quite tough in terms of economics, but we have economic background up to 12th, but still the paper is quite difficult. I think paper was difficult. Paper, they do ask application based questions. So if you are not having conceptual clarity, you will struggle. So it's like, what will happen when inflation will go up, what will happen to the repo rate, and what will be happen to the exchange rate. So it's like a relationship based, they are asking question. So if you understand the subject carefully, it will be easy for you to tackle these kind of questions. Okay, next that we have the question. Hindi mein class, no, Hindi mein nahi hota, it's almost everything is in English. Whatever English I'm speaking, the level would remain same, because we have students from northeastern part of our country and South India. So Hindi would be difficult for them. Next that we are, sir, I've seen numericals in the optional. You are telling mathematical economics is not the part of the syllabus. Please explain. See, mathematical economics is not there in the syllabus. You can also see the syllabus, okay? If you see the syllabus, can you able to find differentiation? You will able to find calculus, you'll able to find matrices, input output model, linear programming. These are not. So obviously the mathematics is not the part. They ask question based on the equation. So if you are understanding equation on the basis of mathematics, that is, you are like not able to understand what is maths and what is not. Pooja, I told you that in economics option they ask mathematics, but that is related to equation only, okay? Like cost function, like income determination model, so ISLM equation, the expenditure method equation. So they will give you figures, you have to just put it into that, okay? And then you have to calculate with the simple maths. Someone is asking, sir, is it possible to score 400 marks in economics option? I don't think so it is possible, because paper 2 is purely theoretical and it's difficult to score good in theoretical. Neutralization is there, so they do that, so don't worry about it, because they neutralize the marks, okay? I think that's it. All the doubts I have entertained and I have answered that. So that's the end of the session. Make sure, if you are interested, you can join the batch, because the next batch will come next year, that is in July 2021, after the preliminary examination. So this is the last chance that you can join the economics optional for 2020 as well as 2021. We are going to finish this course in 3 months with double classes, okay? One in the morning and one session in the evening. You'll get the study material, all the classes would be live. Later on also you can access. The validity of the course would be 1 month. You'll get the study material, we'll discuss previous year question papers, all in the live classes, okay? And weekly test you'll get equivalent to the level of UPSC. If you want to see the sample test, you can just download the Ecoholics mobile app, where you will get the sample test of the test series as well as sample test for the weekly test. If you're not able to find any of this thing, you can contact on the numbers given on the screen. Okay, so that's it. Graph creates a problem. Don't worry, graphs are very easy. And if you understand graph, you will feel that graph is the only thing where you can fetch marks. Okay, so जो चीज़ हमने पढ़ी नहीं है वो हमको कठिन ही लगेगी, है ना? जैसे आज तक आपने इकोनॉमिक्स नहीं पढ़ा होगा तो इकोनॉमिक्स कठिन लगता है, समझ रहे हैं ना बात को? तो जो चीज़ पढ़ेंगे हम वो आसान लगेगी, और ग्राफ बहुत आसान है. इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड द रिलेशनशिप, आपको ग्राफ बहुत पसंद आएंगे, ठीक है? चलो, ओके, थैंक यू सो मच, थैंक यू फॉर ट्यूनिंग इन. विल मीट नेक्स्ट संडे 9:30 PM. Till then, see you soon. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe Ecoholics, and download the app to get my ebook for free. That is very important for UPSC preliminary examination. Only 186 pages compiled book you can find on the Ecoholics mobile app. If you're not able to find it, just send a WhatsApp message on my number, you'll get that book automatically. Okay, thank you so much. Pooja is asking one thing, how would you take doubts? Like I'm taking right now, the same model, okay? I take doubts. So for MA economics, yes, agriculture economics is a good thing, okay? You said it will be validity of the course would be 1 year. Okay, if I by mistake I said that it's 1 month, the validity of the course would be 1 year from the date of your registration. Okay, and we'll provide full support till your examination, next examination. Okay, we do the classes, we provide classes for budget and economic survey, each and every chapter with one lecture. Okay, so comprehensive coverage of budget and economic survey, that too. Okay. Sir, I'm in intermediate in LSC Maths, Eco Calculus, CMS 12. I think in economics they ask the application of calculus with economic theory, not pure calculus. Okay. Timing of the batches would be 8 to 9 in the evening and in the morning as well. Yes. Okay. I think I've done with this. Thank you so much. Make sure that you download our app where a lot of freebies are there, like ebooks and the question papers, so you can go and collect that. Thank you so much. Take care. Yes, Abhishek, it is possible. Okay, MA Economics after BCom is possible. Total fees you can see on the link. Okay. See, Pooja, now you can ask the question later on. You can call me tomorrow at 11 a.m. I'll answer all your questions. Don't worry about maths. Maths is not the part of optional, okay? Thank you so much, everyone. Good night, take care. And don't forget to subscribe Ecoholics, because we are coming up with a lot of sessions regarding optional and other things. Okay, thank you so much, good night.